We have 100,000 plus eyes within us, each eye having a will of its own. Does this mean that man number 7 has all 100,000 plus wills diminished to one permanent will? This seems unattainable to me. First of all, this question is formatory. It's completely formatory. It's philosophy. It's insane. We have no chance of, we have no possibility of knowing what man number 7 is at this point. We can't even discern what man number 4 is. What does it mean to be balanced? What does it mean to have all of your centers balanced? To have your instinctive, moving instinctive center balanced, your emotional center balanced, your intellectual center balanced. What does it mean? It means that, let's just take the intellectual center. So in the intellectual center, you have an intellectual center, you have an emotional center, and you have an instinctive moving center. And within the intellectual center of the intellectual center, you have an intellectual center, an emotional center, an instinctive moving center. And within each of those, they're broken down again. So what does it mean to have them all balanced? We are not even aware of the intellectual center. We're not even aware of the emotional. I say, well, was that the emotional part of your intellectual center, or was that the moving part of your intellectual center? And if you answer me, you lie, because you don't know, because you are not aware of that. We are unconscious. It's like, well, how do I know I have that? Well, why don't you look and see? Well, it's just what you're saying. I don't believe that. Fine. Then look and see. Prove that I'm wrong by verifying that I'm wrong. Or prove that I'm right by verifying that I'm right. Well, I don't have to do that. That's right. You don't have to do that. You can go the way of all flesh. You can go the same way that all organic life on this planet is going. You could be recycled. Because that's what all organic life on this planet is constantly doing. It's constantly being recycled. It's arising and passing away, arising and passing away. It's being born, it's dying. It's growing up, it's growing old, it's growing out, it's dying, it's being born again. It just goes on and on. The trees, they drop their leaves this time of year. They'll start to drop their leaves. Those leaves will begin to turn to mulch. That mulch will be eaten by bacteria. That'll all be turned into the earth. And then new plants and new greenery will grow up from that. And it will go on and on and on, like it's gone on and on and on. And the sea will purify all the waste and garbage that we put into it until we finally put so much into it that not even the oceans themselves can keep up with the destruction that we can do. And so what will happen is we'll finally destroy organic life on this planet. Well, what does that really mean? It means that the offensive virus will destroy itself. And organic life on this planet will continue to rebalance itself. So, in a sense, a balanced man, in one sense, the ordinary man, is just a man who grows, does what he does in life, then dies, and the worms and the bacteria eat him, and then they go on living, and that's the end of that. He's a balanced man because he's balanced out. But we're talking about a different kind of purpose for man. We're talking about a different way for man to go, not the way of all flesh, not the way of organic life on this planet, but for man to turn away from that and to head in a different direction and develop another part of himself, a part of his consciousness that he is now not conscious of, not aware of. And part of that is knowing the centers that you have inside of you, how they work, why they are not in balance, why one center is working for another center, why your emotional center is doing your thinking for you, or why your thinking center is doing your moving for you, or why your moving center is doing your thinking for you. And we'll just take it on just take three centers. Just take the intellectual center, the emotional center, and the moving center. And leave the instinctive center alone because it's doing fine without you. It doesn't need you breathing for it. It doesn't need you beating its heart for it. It doesn't need you circulating blood or digesting food. It doesn't need your interference. Your interference could only mess you up. It only messes up the body. So we leave that alone because it's working just fine. It knows how to do its job. But the parts that we are in, that we are supposed to be in control of, those are the parts that are so wacky. Instead of thinking, we have this formatory apparatus. We slap back and forth from yes, no, right, wrong, hot, cold, black, white, all the extremes. We go back and forth, and there's no middle ground for us. We need to train ourselves to find a middle ground. So we need to train ourselves to be in the intellectual center and to direct our thinking, to actually give attention to something and to keep our attention there for a little while. A little while could be anywhere from 2 to 9 seconds. You know, 10 seconds is pressing it for most people. 10 seconds, give your attention to something for 10 seconds. I can do that. No, you can allow something to take your attention for 10 seconds or maybe an hour or maybe 2 hours. You can be totally absorbed in a book. But that doesn't mean that you are directing your attention. It means that it is holding your attention. If you can't see the difference, it's because you have not observed yourself. If you've not observed yourself with proper self-observation, then you can't see the difference. This whole thing about 100,000 plus eyes within us, I don't know how many eyes are in us. I don't know where you came up with the number 100,000 plus. I don't know. I have no idea how many eyes are in us. What I do know is that I don't know how many eyes are in us. I don't know how many eyes are in me. I can't label them. I can't name them. I can't tell you where they are, who's running what, when, because I'm unconscious. Now, there is more consciousness and less consciousness. I can be more conscious. I can be less conscious. But I'm not conscious of 100,000 eyes. Now, so I don't really know if man number 7 would have 100,000 wills diminished to one permanent will or not. I don't know. What I imagine and what I understand from what people who have awakened more than I am awake have said is that what happens, and I can prove this in scale because it's very much like what happens to me now. Now, there are a number of eyes, and they all have something to say. But there are a group of work eyes. There's a group of work eyes, and they're saying, look, I understand everybody has something to say, but we can't all talk at once. The group of work eyes submits all of the soliloquies that all of these eyes have, each individual soliloquy, submits them all to the work principles. The principles that I actually have been able to verify and that I can accept. It submits them and says, okay, well, this is a negative emotion. We're not going to allow this to express. Well, this is a negative emotion. We're not going to allow this to express. Well, this has nothing to do with the subject, so we're not going to allow it to express. So it filters out and subdues, basically, the eyes that really, the little mechanical eyes that really have nothing to say, that don't even really understand the work. It takes bigger eyes to understand the work. It takes more intelligent eyes to understand the work. The work eyes group together and they start to filter through the principles of the work what these eyes have to say. And so they become subdued or subjugated to the will of the work eyes, the group of work eyes. Is that understandable? Good.